year, marking not only a change in season, but the typical time of a year home sales spring into action. NBC5's Jennifer Elliott has the latest on the local housing market.
Lynn Green just sold her West Medford home. It was on the market for 2 days.
I was shocked, yeah. I'm so shocked.
John L. Scott realtor Alice Lima says Green's experience isn't all that uncommon. The spring thaw is really heating up our local housing market.
The demand is very high. We have a lot of starving buyers out there.
Lima took us inside one home currently for sale in our area.
Granite countertops.
She says new listings are popping up like daisies.
Since March 1st, we're seeing 40, 50, and 60 homes listed every day.
Lima says prices continue to rise, but slower than last year, indicating stabilization. But that doesn't mean a seller's market is set in stone. Foreign relations can impact the smallest of regions.
It's weird to think that somebody in Medford is impacted by what's going on with the airline tragedy, with some of the fighting overseas, and also with some of the civil unrest in some of the other countries. But it does affect our Medford market, our Ashland market, our Jacksonville market, because so many of our residents are making their living as professional investors.
And with deals harder to find, supply could easily overwhelm demand.
It's going to be an exciting spring, but it's going to be bumpy.
So exciting that Green recently got her own realtor's license.
I mean, this was a good experience for me, and if you're willing to put in a little elbow grease and, you know, a little bit of money, there's still good deals out on the market.
Now she plans on helping others buy and sell homes, just as she did this last week. In Medford, Jennifer Elliott, NBC5 News.
And here's a new housing market trend expected. The medical marijuana dispensary law is expected to lead to an increase in commercial property values. Lima says to watch prices, especially in Ashland and Klamath Falls.